Hi everyone, Bianca here, welcome to a new tutorial. I have here a metal ring of 30 centimeters. In another tutorial I made also this one here of 20 centimeters. You find this also on my YouTube channel in a Dutch language and in English. You can find also a written pattern on my website. In that tutorial I told you also that I have a bigger ring of 30 centimeters. This one here, also with a little eye here on the top with a cord in it. I'm going to work with only one color, cotton 8 from Scheepjes. If we look at the label, then we have to work with a 3mm crochet hook. But I want my stitches a little bit tighter, smaller. So I'm going to work with a 2.5mm crochet hook. We start with a magic circle on the hook. Then we make one chain. This chain counts for nothing, it's only to tie up a stitch. In the magic circle we make 10 single crochets in total. Enter your hook in the magic circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, that's 1. Back in the same circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, that's 2. 10 in total, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and the last, that's 10. Okay, pull on that short tail to close the magic circle and make on the top of the first single crochet a slip stitch. Here's that chain, counts for nothing. Go to the next real stitch. The first single crochet under through that V, on the top of that stitch. Grab your yarn, pull through and pull through, and round one is complete. Round 2. In this round you make double crochets all the way around. You start with a first chain 3. 1, 2, 3. And this counts for a first double crochet. Now back in that same stitch where you make a slip stitch in the previous round, make one double crochet in that same stitch. Yarn over, enter your hook in that same stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over and pull for 2. Now we have 2 double crochets in the same stitch. We make in the next stitch also 2 double crochets in the same stitch. Enter your hook in the next stitch, make 1 double crochet and back in that same stitch for a second double crochet. So we have also a group of 2 double crochets. So we work all the way around. Into the next stitch, 2 double crochets in that same stitch. 10 times in total, so we have on the end of this round 20 double crochets in total. We close with a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet. I'm all the way around. Now we make a slip stitch in the first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch. 1, 2 and 3. Go in with your hook, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through. Round 3. We start with a first double crochet and that's a chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Back into that same stitch where we make that slip stitch in the previous round, make one more double crochet in that same stitch. So we have two double crochets in the same stitch. Now make a chain two. One and two. We skip one stitch. This stitch here. And then into the next stitch, make two double crochets in the same stitch. One, back in that same stitch for a second. And then make a chain two. This is the way how we work all the way around. So we skip the next stitch. And then into the next stitch, two double crochets in the same stitch. One, back in that same stitch. Two, and then a chain two. Work like this all the way around, and then we close on the top of the first double crochet with a slip stitch. On the end of this round, we have 10 times a group of two double crochets with between a chain two. After that last group of two double crochets, you have to make also that chain two. Now we close on the top of the first double crochet with a slip stitch in the third chain stitch. Cup your yarn, pull through and pull through. Round 4, we start with a slip stitch into the next stitch. That's the stitch after that chain 3 in the first double crochet here on top. A slip stitch. And we make also one slip stitch in that chain 2 space here. Now we can start here in that chain two space. We make a first double crochet, that's a chain three. Now back in that same chain two space, make one double crochet, chain two, one and two, and back in that same chain two space with another two double crochets. One, back in that same space, two. Now we have here with your first chain three, two double crochets, chain two, two double crochets in that same chain two space. This is the way how we work all the way around. We skip the next two double crochets. In the next chain two space, make also two double crochets in that space. One and two, then in chain two. Two double crochets back in that same chain two space. So one and two. Work like this all the way around. We skip the next two double crochets. In the next chain two space also two double crochets. Chain two. Two double crochets. On the end of this round, we close with a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet. That's the chain three here. I'm all the way around, make a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet. That's the chain three in the third chain stitch. Enter your hook, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through. Round 5, we make in the next stitch one slip stitch. This first double crochet here after the chain 3 on the top. And also in the chain 2 space, one slip stitch. So we start in the chain 2 space. Make a chain 3. Counts for a first double crochet. Now back in that same chain 2 space, make 6 double crochets in total. One, two, three, four, five, and six. So we have one shell here of 7 double crochets, including that chain 3 here. Now we skip the next 2 double crochets, and then here in this gap here between the 2 times 2 double crochets in that space here, not on the top of that double crochet here, but in that space between the 2 groups of 2 double crochets, make 1 single crochet in that space. And this is the way how we work all the way around. We skip the next 2 double crochets. In the next chain 2 space, make 7 double crochets for a new shell. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, six and seven for a new shell. Skip the next 2 double crochets, and then here in that space here between the 2 groups of 2 double crochets, make a single crochet. So we work in the next chain 2 space 7 double crochets, and then between here the 2 times 2 double crochets, we work 1 single crochet all the way around. I made all my shells. I have to make 1 more single crochet in this last space here. And then we close also with a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet. That's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch. On the back of my mandala, I work this little till in. I pull the hook a little bit up, and then I turn my little mandala, and I grab a needle, and I pull on this short till to close the magic circle. Now go on the through a little stitch here on the back, then pull through for a second time, on the through that little stitch on the back, make a little loop like this, then go with the needle into that loop and then pull to close. So we have a little knot here on the back. Weave the till in on the back of the stitches. Only in the back of that stitches, you see not that needle here on the front. Then pull through. I skip a little stitch here on the back. I weave the till in. Also to the other side, skip one stitch. And then we can cut off that little tail. Round 6. We start first in the next 3 stitches with a slip stitch. into the next stitch. One slip stitch here on the top, on the through that V. Also a slip stitch into the next stitch and also into the next stitch. So we start here in the center of that first shell. On the top of that shell we make a first popcorn. And the first popcorn stitch is a little bit different than the rest. We start with a first double crochet, that's in chain 3. One, two, and three. Now go back into that same stitch with 4 double crochets, all in that same stitch. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we have 5 double crochet, including that chain 3 here in the beginning. We close the popcorn. We have to make a little loop. And then we go out with the hook. I place my finger in so we cannot lose that loop. And we go with the crochet hook to the first double crochet. That's a chain 3. On the top of the third chain stitch, go in with your hook. Then place that loop from your finger back on the hook, pull to close, and then pull through that first stitch on the hook. So we have here our first popcorn stitch. After that first popcorn stitch, we make a chain 9. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Eight and 9. After that chain 9, we have to make our second popcorn stitch here on the second shell, in the middle of that shell. So we have to skip 7 stitches after that first popcorn stitch. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then into the next stitch, that's the middle point of the next shell. We make a new popcorn stitch. In that stitch on the top, 5 double crochets, all in that same stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We make a loop. Out with the hook, go to the first double crochet of that shell for 5, on the through that V on the top, place the loop back on the hook and pull through that first double crochet. And then make and chain 9. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And this is the way how we work all the way around. Skip the next 7 stitches, make a popcorn stitch on the next shell, and then and chain 9. When we all the way around and we have to make the last popcorn stitch here, we have also make a chain 9. Now we close here on the first stitch with a slip stitch. That's on the back of that popcorn here. Yarn over, pull through and pull through. Now you see your work is a little bit of cupping, but don't worry, it will be flat again. Round 7. You start with a first double crochet, that's a chain 3. 1, 2, 3. After that first double crochet, we make one chain stitch. So we have to make one more chain. So we have here 4 chain stitches. Skip the next stitch, that's the first chain of 9. And then into the next stitch, make 1 double crochet. Chain 1, skip the next stitch, then into the next stitch, 1 double crochet. A chain, skip 1 stitch, into the next stitch, 1 double crochet. Make 1 chain, skip 1 stitch, into the next stitch, 1 double crochet. Chain 1, and now on the top of the first double crochet, make also 1 double crochet. On the top of that double crochet, this stitch here on the back. Here, also 1 double crochet. This is the way how we work all the way around. I'll show you once more. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch, into the next stitch, 1 double crochet. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch, into the next stitch, 1 double crochet. Then a chain, skip 1 stitch, into the next stitch, 1 double crochet. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch, 1 double crochet into the next stitch. Chain 1, and then on the back of that popcorn stitch, also 1 double crochet. And this stitch here. And that's the second repeat, so we work all the way around. Then we close also with a slip stitch. I worked all my stitches all the way around. After that last double crochet, we have to make also 1 chain. Now on the top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3, in the third chain stitch, we close with a slip stitch. 1, 2, 3 in that stitch. Round 8. We start with a first slip stitch here in the first chain 1 space. Just go in with your hook in that space, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through. Make a chain 3. Counts for a first double crochet. Now back in that same space, make 1 double crochet. Chain 1 and 2 more double crochets back in that same chain 1 space. So 1, and 2. Now we have here 2 double crochets, chain 1, 2 double crochets in that same chain 1 space. Now we skip the next stitch and then into the next chain 1 space make 1 single crochet. And this is the repeat we work all the way around. We skip the next double crochet, in the next chain 1 space we make 2 double crochets, chain 1, 2 double crochets. It's 1, 2, chain 1, 2 double crochets back in that same space. It's 1 and 2. Now we skip the next double crochet, in the next chain 1 space make 1 single crochet. The next repeat, skip the next double crochet, into the next chain 1 make 2 double crochets. Chain 1, 2 double crochets. Then skip the next double crochet, in the next chain 1 space 1 single crochet. Work like this all the way around and then we close on the top of the first double crochet with a slip stitch in the third chain stitch. Ik heb mijn laatste twee stokjes, losse twee stokjes, in die ruimte gemaakt hier. Voor de laatste ruimte. In die laatste ruimte ga je dan nog een vaste maken. En dan maken we een halve vaste boven de top van het allereerste stokje. En dat zijn die drie lossen. 1, 2, 3 in de derde losse. Round 9. We start with a first slip stitch here in the next stitch. And make also one slip stitch in the chain 1 space. Now we make loops all the way around. Make a chain 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 and then we make 1 slip stitch back in that same chain 1 space. So we have here our first loop of a chain 6. Now make a chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now we skip the next 5 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then in the next chain 1 space make also 1 slip stitch. And this is the repeat we work all the way around. We make a little loop again of a chain 6. Back in that same chain 1 space with a slip stitch. Then make a chain 5, skip the next 5 stitches and then in the next chain 1 space make a slip stitch. And then a chain 6, slip stitch back in that same chain 1 space for a new loop. Then a chain 5. Skip the next 5 stitches and make 1 slip stitch in the next chain 1 space, all the way around. Make a slip stitch in the next chain 1 space, chain 6 for a new loop, slip stitch back in that same chain 1 space, chain 5, then in the next chain 1 space also 1 slip stitch and then on the top a new loop. after that last loop of that chain 6, this loop here, we have to make also a chain 5. Then we close with a slip stitch on the top of the first stitch, that's here under that first loop. Now we have in total 25 loops of chain 6 in total. We start on round 10 with a slip stitch in the first chain 6 loop. Then make one double crochet, that's a chain 3. Two more double crochets back in that same chain 6 space. It's 1 and 2. Chain 1 back in that same loop of that 6 chain stitches with 3 double crochets. Now here in the next chain 5 space, make 1 single crochet. In the next chain 6 loop space, we make also 3 double crochets. It's 1, 2, and 3. Chain 1, 3 double crochets back in that same loop space. And this is the third one. Now in that chain 5 space, make 1 single crochet. And this is the way how we work all the way around. Are you all the way around? Then we close with a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch. Round 11, we make a slip stitch in the next 2 stitches, that's 1, into the next 2, and we work also a slip stitch in the chain 1 space. You make a first double crochet, that's in chain 3, 1, 2, 3. Now make in that same chain 1 space 2 more double crochets, 1 and 2, then make a chain 1, back in that same space 3 more double crochets, it's 1, 2 and 3. Now we skip over the next chain 1 space here in that point. So we skip the next 7 stitches. 3 double crochets in that space. It's 1, 2, 3, chain 1. Back in that same chain 1 space with 3 more double crochets. And this is the third one. This is the repeat we work all the way around. Skip the next 7 stitches. Then in the next chain 1 space, make 2 more times a group of 3 double crochets with between and chain 1. It's 1, 2, and 3 double crochets, chain 1. 3 more double crochets back in that same space. So work all your stitches all the way around, and then we close also here in the top of the first double crochet with a slip stitch. I'm all the way around, make a slip stitch here on the first double crochet that chain 3. Round 12, the final round of this mandala, then we attach that mandala to the ring. We start around the first double crochet, and that's the chain 3, with a back post single crochet. Go around that chain 3 from the back to the front, front to the back, around that chain 3, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull for 2. Now make a chain 2. And this here counts for a first back post double crochet. Around the next 2 stitches, work a back post double crochet. Yarn over and hook from behind to the front, from the front to the back. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2. Also around the next double crochet. From the back to the front, front to the back, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over and pull for 2. We have here 3 back post double crochets. In that chain 1 space, make a new popcorn stitch. 5 double crochets, all in that same chain 1 space. That's 3, 4 and 5. Then go out with your hook. Go to the first double crochet of 5, this stitch here, place the loop back on the hook and pull through for a popcorn. To close the popcorn, we make a chain 1. Now around the next 3 double crochets, make 1 back post double crochet. From behind, that's 1, around the next stitch and back post double crochet, that's 2, and 1 more time, and that's 3. And this is the repeat you work all the way around. I'm all the way around. And then we close with a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the beginning. It's 1, 2 and 3 in the third chain stitch, make a slip stitch. Then the mandala is complete. I place a little blanket on my table, otherwise we have a lot of noise of this iron ring. I place the mandala in the middle and you see the mandala is smaller than the ring. Now we can nicely stretch the mandala. The last round. We start with a chain 1. Counts for nothing, it's only to high up a stitch. Now back in that same stitch where you make that slip stitch in the previous round, make 1 single crochet. Back in that same stitch. Also in the next 2 stitches, 1 single crochet. It's 1 and the next 2. Now we make a chain 5. 1. 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now I took that hook out of my work and we go with the chain 5 around the ring. So I pull a loop all the way up, go out with the hook and then we fold that chain 5 around the ring. From the front to the back, over the top and then here under. Came out with your chain stitch, then also that ball of yarn under the through that ring as well, otherwise that thread will get tangled. to the ring. That's not what we want. Also, go with your ball under through that ring and place the hook back into that loop here. And then pull too tight. Then we skip the popcorn and the chain stitch. And then we have to work in the next 6 stitches, 1 single crochet. So into the first stitch, make 1 single crochet. That's 1. Into the next stitch. 2. Into the next. 3. 4. 5. And 6. And this is how we work all the way around. We start with the second repeat. Make a chain 5. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go out with your hook. Then place that chain 5 around the ring. Like this, over the top. And also that ball of yarn under through the ring. So your working tail is on the top of the ring. Place the hook back. And then on the top of the next 6 back post double crochets, work 1 single crochet. 6 single crochets in total. It's 1. Well, my yarn is splitting. I do this stitch once more over. In the first stitch, 1 single crochet. Yeah. Okay. Next stitch, single crochet. That's number 2. Into the next. 3, 4, 5, and 6. And the second repeat is complete. We start with the next repeat. Make a chain 5. Go out at your hook. Place that chain 5 over the ring. Also your ball of yarn under through that ring like this. Then skip the next popcorn and chain stitch, and then in the next 6 back post double crochets you work 1 single crochet, 6 in total. This is the way how we work all the way around. Work like this all your stitches, and then in the beginning I'll show you how to make an invisible join. On the end of this round you work here, after that last loop, 3 more single crochets. Now we cut the yarn to create an invisible join. And I zoom a little bit in so you can see what I'm doing. Cut the yarn, not too short. Then pull your hook all the way up to open that last stitch. Okay, like this. Now you grab a needle. And we skip the first stitch. In the beginning we have to make a chain stitch, counts for nothing. We skip also that stitch. This is the first single crochet. We skip also that stitch. That's the first real stitch. We go to the second stitch, the second single crochet, under through that V from the front to the back, pull through. Now you go to the last single crochet that you work of this round. Then only in the back loop of that stitch, here on the top of that V, enter your needle, pull through. And this here, this V here is your invisible join. Now turn your work. And now we make a little knot on the back. Go under through a few stitches, only in the back of the stitches. Then pull through, not too tight. You want to see that last invisible join. Go under through a little thread here, that same place. And then make a little loop like this. Now enter your needle through that loop and then pull to create a little knot. And now wave that tail in on the back of the stitches, and then only in the back of the stitches like this. You don't have to see that needle on the front here. If you work in the back of the stitches, now go to the other side, skip one stitch. Also once more to the other side, skip one stitch. And then you can cut off really short that working tail. So, and the mandala is complete. You can see that your mandala is not very tight in the ring, because then you lose the effect of these loops. If you want the mandala tighter in the ring, you can make the last loops of the chain 5 only in chain 3 stitches. But I think it's beautiful on this way. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new tutorial from me. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!